okay. Check it out. It's Santana again. Stepping now. One of them brand new big boy toys. I do big boy things. I make big boy
noise. Hi, this is Wise Lad, and today on Bachelor Cooking, I'm going to show you how you can prepare a delicious omelet on a stainless steel pan. I know some of you are saying, I've cooked eggs before on stainless steel and it just sticks like crazy. Well, today I'm going to show you how to do it using the proper heat settings so that the omelet will slide right out of the pan and into your plate. Okay, so the first principle I'm going to go through is called mise en place, which is basically a fancy French word that means have everything ready to go. So as you can see here, I've got cheddar cheese, sautéed mushroom and onions, freshly cut Roma tomatoes, two eggs here that I'm going to beat up for my omelet. I've got salt, pepper, Frank's Red Hot, my butter, and my utensils at hand ready to go. Now the point of this is so that everything is ready to go once you want to put the eggs to the heat. The last thing you want to do is put the eggs to the heat and still be waiting for your onions to saute or find the need to go cut up something in the meantime. So at this point, what I'm going to do is heat up my stainless steel pan. Now this is a very important step, so I'm going to preheat it. I'm going to turn it on to about medium low, on the high side of medium low, so that would be medium low. We're going to do it on the high side of medium low. We're going to let it heat up. Now this is a very important principle, because if you put cold eggs
to a cold pan, you get a sticky mess.
Okay. So that's not a good thing. What we want to do is wait for the pan to heat up, then add the butter, and then add the egg. So that's the process we're going to go through. Now I'm going to give you some tips on knowing when the right time to add the butter is, and then when the right time to add the eggs is. But for right now, we're going to wait for about 3 to 4 minutes for this pan to heat up. Now my pan is still preheating, and it's getting pretty hot now. Now a test that I can do is put some water on it to see how hot it's going. So I'm just going to get a little splash with my fingers, put in there, see how the water starts to evaporate and kind of jump off a little bit. We're almost there. Alright, so we're just about ready to go here. Let's try the water test one more time. See how it jumps off immediately? That means the pan is good and hot. I'm just going to turn that down a smidgen. Okay, and we're going to go ahead and add the butter now. Now we want to add approximately a tablespoon, maybe a tablespoon and a half of butter. And I like butter, so I don't mind putting a little bit more. Plus it helps with the non-stick magic that's going to happen here. Now, butter is sizzling right away. It's melting. I'm just going to go ahead and start moving that around. Now we don't want the butter to burn, but we do want it to basically kind of almost get to brown. And right when it almost gets to brown, that's when we want to go ahead and put in the eggs. As you can see, the butter is just about to brown, so I'm going to go ahead and put the eggs in there now. And what you should hear is a good strong sizzle. That's what you want to hear. There it is. Now, important thing, what you want to do is let it sit there. Let the eggs do its thing. Right now, the eggs are getting nice and happy. They're coagulating. You'll see a ridge that is forming around the eggs. That's good. You want it to set a little bit before you start to mess with it and do anything. Let it do its thing. Now after the eggs have had a chance to cook a little bit, you can start to move around the edges. What you want to do is push towards the center, tilt the pan, move the egg down so that all the egg gets cooked. Push in, tilt, let the egg cook. Push in, tilt, let the egg cook. Push in, tilt, let the egg cook. There. Now, the egg is cooked. When you can tell when no more juice is running around the top. Now it's time to add the ingredients. We've got cheese, cheddar cheese. This is Tillamook cheese. I love it. We've got sauteed onions. Just kind of throw that on there. Spread it out a little bit. Roma tomatoes. Beautiful. Let's go ahead and pop that on right there, like that. Beautiful colors. Eggs are nice and cooked. Throw a little bit of salt right there, like that. And we're ready to go. So at this point, I'm just gonna check the sides again, make sure that we're nice and loosey-goosey. At this point, we're ready to plate. So I'm gonna grab my plate, just a plain white plate, and see how the eggs just move around like that? There's no sticking, okay? This will just easily, again, like I said, come right off the pan and into the plate, just like that. And then a little flip at the end. Boom, there you go. Delicious omelet. Now that's a man-sized omelet right there. That's a bachelor-sized omelet. So I'm gonna chow down on that in a minute. Finish it, turn off the heat. Look at the pan. Beautiful pan. It's almost spotless. Now there's a little bit, just a tiny little bit of sticking, but that'll come off really easily with a sponge and some soap. So easy cleanup. Again, you can do this in the stainless steel pan. It's not hard if you follow the steps I've shown you. Well, all right, YouTube, this is Wise Lat with Bachelor Cooking. I hope you enjoyed this presentation. This is my beautiful omelet, and I'm about to sit down and eat. Again, really simple. You can prepare on a stainless steel pan just by putting in the eggs at the right temperature with the right amount of butter. It'll slide off right out of your pan into your plate. Real easy. You don't need to buy a coated pan every year and worry about overheating it and breathing in fumes that are dangerous to your body. You can do it in a stainless steel pan. It's eco-friendly, and the pan will last you a lifetime. Bon appetit. Until next time, this is Wise Lat with Bachelor of Cooking. Peace. Let's see how this tastes here. It's pretty good. Mmm. Really good. Delicious. Well, this is Wise Lat, and appreciate you joining us. Because I'm plural. Well, YouTube, that's it. I'm about to enjoy my delicious plate of freshly made stuff.